Evan Dyer joins me now live from Ottawa. Evan, the full text of the deal hasn't been released yet, but we do know, what do we know about what it could mean for dairy products sold in Canada?
Well, we do know that the Canadian dairy market is going to be opened up to the extent that from now on 3.25%, 3.25% of the dairy products sold in Canada can come from TPP countries. There are about 11 other countries that it could come from, but in practice we're really talking about the United States, because milk is a perishable product and it's unlikely to be shipped here from the other side of the Pacific Ocean. In the U.S. case, 85% of the milk that comes from the U.S. has to be processed in Canada, but this is still a first in the sense that we've never had fluid milk coming across the border. We've had other products, processed cheese and so on, so already Canadians, when they get a frozen pizza, might be eating U.S. cheese, but we've never seen fluid milk. And the fact that it's going to be processed in Canada, or most of it would be, might sound like it would deal with any concerns. But in the case of growth hormone, it really doesn't. Because growth hormone is not about what's done to the milk. It's about what's done to the cow that produces the milk. So while Canada has said that under the TPP, we'll apply the same phytosanitary standards to American milk that we apply to Canadian milk, that won't address the issue of growth hormones in cows.
If you can, go through, you started to talk about there's concern of what it does to the cow that produces the milk. What do you mean?
Well, it's growth hormone, of course, is a natural product in our own bodies. It's produced by our own glands, which is why we grow. But in this case, what's being done is that a synthetic version of it is being taken, and it's being given to the cow in additional amounts, because that stimulates the production of milk. Now, that practice is actually banned in Canada. It's banned in several other TPP countries like Australia and New Zealand that have big dairy industries, banned in the European Union, but it's not banned in the United States. That doesn't mean that all cows in the United States are given growth hormone. It's actually only about 1 in 5, according to surveys by the U.S. Department of Agriculture. And the concern also, from the Canadian government's point of view, is not about human health. There has been a study in Canada into the effects on human health of growth hormones in cows, and none was found to exist. Rather, in Canada, the product is banned because of concerns about animal welfare, and the same thing is true in those other countries too. But we do know that consumers don't like the idea of having milk that comes from cows fed growth hormones, and dairy producers are concerned that it might have an impact on their brand, on Canadian consumers' desire to drink milk if they feel it might have this in it.
Okay, so that's been their essential reaction, the impact on the brand?
Yeah. Okay. And that becomes a major concern if the product is blended. So, for example, if U.S. milk comes into Canada and gets mixed up with Canadian milk, Canadian dairy producers will no longer be able to put on their little blue cow label, the one that says hormone-free. So they're concerned that there'll be a loss of credibility and potentially a loss of market, and that they won't have that sort of value-added ability to reassure consumers who are worried about this.